Tihi mauri ora. Kia ora koutou katoa, whānau, me ngā iwi katoa, o ngā haue whā e whakarongo mai rā I tēnei wā. Nau mai, haere mai, whakarongo mai ki te reo irirangi o Arrow FM, Wairarapa. Well, welcome to another episode of Tribal Nations Radio, whānau. I'm back, my name's Clinton. I've been away for a couple of weeks and the helm has been looked after by Brother Darcy and his wife, Linda. So thank you, whānau, for your input there. And sorry, folks, I'm not as handsome as Brother Darcy, but I might. It's okay if you're looking. If you're not looking at me and you're listening on the radio, I'm sure I might have a voice for radio, but not a face for TV. But anyway, welcome along. This is Tribal Nations broadcasting out of Arrow FM in the Wairarapa on 92.7. I'd like to thank and acknowledge Arrow FM for their great support in giving us the slot here to talk about the things that Tribal Nations wants to talk about. And one of the things that Tribal Nations is concerned about, folks, is suicide, and particularly teenage suicide. And to that effect, we will be running a rat's ride in the Wairarapa this coming Labour weekend. We'll be riding out of Featherston on the 27th of October, Sunday, this Labour weekend. And you can register down there if you've got a motorbike from 9 o'clock. And you can get a spot prize too. Registrations will be $20. Get a ticket for a spot prize. There'll be a barbecue down there for everybody. And it stands up at approximately 10:30. We intend to ride through Martinborough, Greytown, Carterton and Masterton, and we're going to be ending up in Farrier's Car Park to have a bit of an event for our community to talk about the kaupapa and to help raise awareness against teenage suicide. So to all the whānaus out there that have been affected by this terrible affliction of suicide in the last few weeks, aroha. Nui ki a koutou whānau. Big love to you all. Our club has been affected by this in a couple of ways in the last few weeks, and we're feeling the mamai, and we've had enough of that. And I'd just like to encourage folks out there, and especially our young ones, if you are not feeling that well, please communicate those feelings to your peer group, to your loved ones, because once you start talking about it, then we can find some help, and there's help available out there. There is a lot of help. There's some help with just being able to talk to your friends and family about it. But if you're uncomfortable about that, there are some resources out there that are available for everybody, and you can free call or text on 1737 any time to talk with a trained counsellor. So please, whānau, if you're feeling a little bit depressed or down, or you notice that one of your loved ones is there as well, sometimes you've got to be pretty astute to pick up on these things, because a lot of the time they put up a bit of a facade. But the statistics have shown that if you can get them to stop and rethink and reset and not carry on with their intentions, there is some hope on the other side, and they are grateful that they didn't do what they intended to do. So it is worthwhile, even at just being direct and upfront and reaching out, whānau, kōrero, kōrero. There's also a lifeline out there on 543 354, Healthline on 0800 611 116, the Depression Helpline on 0800 111 757, or free text 4202. Youthline is there for you young people, whakarongo moi, 0800 376 633, or Samaritans on 0800 726 666. And of course, if it's an emergency, whānau, if it is an emergency, please dial 111. Yes, 1 in 5 New Zealanders experience mental illness at any one time in the year. So that's 1 in 5. That's a you know, that's a bit of a red flag. Look after yourself. Supporting someone with a mental illness can be hard work because it's often ongoing and time consuming. But it's worth it. To save a life, it's worth it. And especially to save a life within your whānau or your peer group or your friends group. So our sympathies and condolences go out to all the whānaus out there who have lost loved ones in the last few weeks. Like I said before, we've been affected by this directly, and we're feeling that pain. And so it's given us a fresh impotence and meaning to do what we're doing with trying to raise awareness and getting people to recognise and getting people to talk about it. Because for so many years, up until the last few years, that it was never talked about. But it's heartening to see that, or to hear, and to see the kōrero and the resources that are going towards these things right now. And I think we've had some good kōrero in the last 2 weeks with Brother Darcy and Linda, not only about King Street Artworks, but about mental illness and those types of things in our community. And so I'd like to acknowledge Anna Cardinal for coming in here and having a kōrero about those things. That was excellent. That was excellent kōrero. If you missed that, I'm sure it's available on Arrow FM on the website. That was a good kōrero. So thank you, Anna, for that. Condolences and sympathies out to the whānaus who have been directly affected by whakamorimori or suicide, and in particular to our local whānau and all the friends who knew Dallas well and who are hurting because of the loss of this talented young man. Our community is a bit rocked at the news that a young talented man like Dallas ended up doing what he had done on the weekend. And we hopefully will be supporting the whānau in some way this coming weekend at his farewell. But what a tragic loss, whānau. A very, very talented young man, well loved by his whānau, well loved by the community, and had a very bright future ahead of him. So it just goes to show that sometimes you might not be able to read those signals and signs that clearly, but if you do, you've got to be pretty aware of what's going on and try and intervene and get them to talk. So condolences and love to the whānau there, and to everyone and to all his friends and whānau. So that's a tragic situation. So Tribal Nations, we're a motorcycle club. We're based all around Aotearoa, New Zealand, and we're a club made up of like-minded people who care about others, who care about our communities. And our mission statement is to support those in the community who are disadvantaged, disenfranchised, and suffering serious illness, neglect, deprivation, abuse, whether physical or emotional, and addictions. So that's the mission statement for Tribal Nations MC. And the club is sort of based on 7 tenants. Very strong tenants, whānau. The first one being manaakitanga, which is about support and helping others. And that speaks to that, and it speaks to helping others and being supportive. So that brings a lot of people to our club, people who have got those values deep within them, within their heart, who like to help other people. They find their way to Tribal Nations. Another tenant, another value that we roll down the road with on our motorcycles is kotahitanga, and that speaks to unity, and that's the unity of all tribes, of all people, and it speaks to the inclusiveness of Tribal Nations, being an inclusive club, being open to all people, all races, all motorbike genres too, and also men and women. We have women full set members in our club. We don't discriminate, we are all inclusive. So unity, kotahitanga, speaks to the tribal nature of our name, which is a clan, tribe, nation. So that's everyone is welcome in our club. The other 5 tenants are family, which is very strong for all of us. Family first is a big thing. A lot of us are very strongly connected to our whānaus and our family. But when you join tribal nations, you become part of the family as well. You become part of the whānau. So that speaks to that as well. It speaks to your family and our family, and we're all whānau. We're all whānau. Acceptance, again, acceptance of all faiths, religions, races, walks of life, no matter where you've been. As long as you can rock with the last three values, you're okay by us, and that's integrity, trust, and honesty. Now, they're pretty strong values, folks, and they keep a lot of people on the straight and narrow. So when people want to know what Tribal Nations is about, and they hear those seven tenets, that speaks volumes to what Tribal Nations is all about. So Tribal Nations was a motorcycle club started up by some visionary people in up in Waikato, up in the Ngarawahia, and brought the kaupapa to the rest of Aotearoa for us to, and we've got chapters all over the country now. There's the North Island's broken up into three regions, Te Hiku, Te Puku and Te Upoko. And the South Island is, has three regions as well, Te Tau Ihu, Te Turu and Te Tau Rapa. And our membership is growing because of the kaupapa. And our kaupapa is, like I just said, manaakitanga, kotahitanga, family, acceptance, integrity, trust and honesty. And we are very concerned about raising money for community organisations. And another kaupapa that we roll with is a Green Ribbon Rats kaupapa, which is riding against teenage suicide. So we're looking forward to riding against teenage suicide and raising awareness. Wairarapa used to have, I think 2 years ago in 2017, one of the worst statistics of a region in the whole country. And it's heartening to see that with the latest statistics, Wairarapa had dropped down. And but there's still some regions that have got a big problem, and one of them's the East Coast up there, East Coast Bay of Plenty, where there's young Māoris and young Polynesians. It's a you really got to start looking out for each other. And and I'd also say, whānau, that there's a bit of drug abuse out there in the community that is not helping the situation. There is the P epidemic that seems to be in some way associated with a lot of these things that are going on. Not all of them, don't get me wrong, it's not all of them, but some of them have been involved with this, and it's not getting called out as much as it should be. It's not getting spoken of, again, like suicide a couple of years ago. There are people in our community who know what's going on. They can see the damage, and they're not saying much about it. And there's others in our community who are peddling and pushing it, and it's no good. It's no good, whānau. You've got to stop this, because it's hurting. It's hurting you. It's hurting the whānaus. It's hurting our whole community. And it's I can see us getting to the point where we're going to have to, we'll probably do something about it in regard to raising awareness about that at some point in the future. But at the moment, we're focusing on the right against teenage suicide. And like I say, it'll be out of Featherston on the 27th of October, Labour Weekend. And riding through all the towns, making some noise, raising awareness, flying green ribbons, raising some money for King Street Artworks. And thanks to the kōrero from Darcy and Linda in the last 2 weeks, We've heard a lot about what King Street Artworks is doing for our community, and it's a valuable resource, whānau, for everybody. What a great asset to our community King Street Artworks is. So we're proud, honoured, and humbled to be able to support King Street Artworks. So we're really looking forward to this Rats Run. We'll be riding through all the Wairarapa and heading towards Masterton. We're going to go through Martinborough, around the square, Greytown, Carterton, and ended up in Farrius Car Park in Masterton, probably about 12:30. And we'll have a corridor there and talk about things, but hopefully not too long, because I know most bikers do suffer from ADHD, and if you don't capture their attention, they tend to wander off and head to other places of refreshment. So hopefully we'll keep that a little bit short and sweet, and we'll capture them also by giving them some spot prizes, encouraging them to stay around and listen to the corridor. So I just want to play a little song, whānau, for everybody out there. It's a everyone's, you know, you're only human, eh?
Thank you.
Welcome back to Tribal Nations MC radio show here on Arrow FM 92.7 in the Wairarapa. My name's Clinton. I'm a member of Tribal Nations MC. We're doing this radio show initially because we're trying to raise awareness against teenage suicide. It's a thing that our motorcycle club's quite concerned about. And we'll be doing a run through the Wairarapa on Labour Weekend and raising money for King Street Artworks. So I'd like to just acknowledge, take a little bit of time to acknowledge some sponsors and supporters of this event, Tribal Nations MC from all over the motu. Tēnā koutou katoa whānau, ka nui taku mihi ki a koutou. Big mihi out to Arrow FM, Michael and Veronica, thank you very much for your support, guidance and tautoko for us and this kaupapa. NZME for your getting some advertising up for us on the radio stations out there, on the other radio stations. Thank you, NZME. Wairarapa Times Age for publishing a couple of articles about the event. Safety and Apparel, they've donated some goods for the spot prizes. Same with Sacred Art Tattoo in Masterton. I'd like to acknowledge them. Thank you very much, whānau. Mitre 10 Mega, they're lending us a truck and a barbecue trailer. So thank you, Aaron Slight and Mitre 10 Mega. The Lions in Carterton will be bringing down a food caravan, because we are probably all aware of the good things that the Lions do for our community anyway. So the Lions will be raising money for themselves, because we know that everything that they do and those things, they all come back to the community anyway. So that's a good thing to have the Lions support. So thanks, Lions, and keep up the good work. I know you've got some really good projects coming up, and there's a special 50th anniversary project coming up in Carterton that the Lions are going to be creating for the community. And it's going to be a junior safety bike park in Carrington Park. So we're quite happy to be supporting the Lions with that as well, because the Lions do a big thing, do lots of good work for our communities. Robin Cherry Campbell, thank you, Robin, for helping organise some logistical things for this event. Leather and Art, Trevor Lamb. Ramrodders Hot Rod Club, thank you for your support, and we'll be supporting them at the Rockabilly coming up on about the 19th of October, I think that one is, over in Otaki. So we'll be supporting Ramrodders again, so thanks, Ramrodders, and looking forward to continuing our relationship. Resines, Wairarapa, Masterton, Pete Maxwell, thanks, Pete. Wairarapa DHB, Anna Cardno, I've mentioned her earlier on in the program, and thanks, Anna, for your tautoko, and she's also organising some advertising for the kaupapa as well. Te Kura Kaupapa or Wairarapa will be coming and doing a couple of items for the event down at Farriers, and we will be making a koha to them as well, because that's a direct hit to our rangatahi. We are want to support our rangatahi as well. That's the main focus, really, folks. When we're writing against teenage suicide, it is for the teenagers. And so it will be an honour to support Kura Kaupapa or Wairarapa. CBK Cafe, thank you. Trust House Farriers, lending us the car park and everything there. Beehive Premier, thank you. And also Lone Star. Thanks, Tom, for giving us some vouchers for spot prizes there as well. So to all those sponsors and supporters, thank you very much for your support. Very much appreciated. Doing a good job for our community, and just keep up the good work, please, folks. It's massive. The Rats Ride, that's coming up in October, Labour Weekend, the 27th. Rats means riding against teenage suicide, and it was the brainchild of some visionary whānau from up north who had been affected by suicide in their whānau, and it was at a time where nothing was said about it. It was quite a taboo subject, and there was no statistics being published, and nothing was printed in the papers, and it was all kept quite quiet, and only those affected by it sort of knew how big the problem was. And as is the case with some smaller communities, some of these smaller Māori communities who seem to be affected more frequently with this problem than perhaps other larger communities, the problem was sort of was able to be seen quite acutely. It was able to be it presented a big problem for the whānaus living in small communities. They were affected by it sometimes week after week, and so it got to the point where some whānau members, some brothers, formed a group called the Super Māori Fellas, and the biker group would combine forces with a registered nurse, Kahui Niho, and they would form the Rats Rider, the Rats genre, and the Rats Ride. And the Rats adopted the same model as the White Ribbon Ride that had been happening around the country for a couple of years before this. So that was sort of like the genesis of these Rats Rides. And anyone can be a Rats Rider, regardless of their affiliations to a club. You don't need to be affiliated to any club. You can just be a person who is concerned about this subject, and bring your bike and be a Rats Rider. You can show some support and for the whānaus, and try and help us raise awareness about it. Anyone can be a Rats Rider, regardless of the affiliation to a club or not. This gives the wider riding community an opportunity to come together and support a kaupapa that affects all communities. The Super Māori Fellas are no strangers to heading up a motorcycle event. They also launched the very first White Ribbon Ride, as I just mentioned, the Men Against Violence campaign back in November 2009. Which is now a national event, and the White Ribbon kaupapa is worldwide. And I'm also a White Ribbon ambassador, whānau, so I will be hopefully, after our Rats Run, we might be able to get the opportunity to carry on having a kōrero about the next kaupapa that's coming up, and that'll be the White Ribbon kaupapa, and that's about violence and anti-violence against women, and respectful relationships. And but Tribal Nations has also got a little bit of a mantra about violence, and Tribal Nations says no violence at all, no violence towards men and children as well, and we're pretty strong on that. So that's where Tribal Nations sits with violence. We're an anti-violence sort of club. We don't like that sort of behaviour. We know it hurts our wairua, it hurts other people, so it's no good. Keeping with the kaupapa of Rats and maintaining the Green Ribbon campaign to this day, the green stone door has always remained open. Te tātou pounamo o te ao, a dedicated group of whānau supporters and motorcycle riders from Ngā Haue Whā continue to row the Rats Waka through the winds, waves and storms of Tawhiri Matea, navigating a safe passage. So the challenge is on. Let us bring on the light and dispel the darkness. Kia ora te mā, ka mate te pango, maurea te taki, wero hia te wero. So yeah, we'll be rocking with that kaupapa whānau when we ride through the Wairarapa with our green ribbons flying. To raise awareness against teenage suicide, and to raise some pūtea, some money for King Street Artworks. So helping others, what can we do? We can learn about their condition, we can keep an eye on each other, we can have each other's backs, understand more about your friend, your family members, conditions, what symptoms to look out for, what can trigger them, and what the different treatment options are. The causes of mental illness are complex and are not the fault of the person with the condition. Just like physical illness, mental illness needs to be treated. This is why the person can't just snap out of it. If someone is diagnosed with a heart problem, they would get it treated and they'd get support to recover. Mental health conditions are the same. The person needs to have treatment and be supported to recover. So keep an eye out for those, you know, get to know your friends and family, and keep an eye out for changes in behaviour, and don't be afraid to talk, encourage each other to talk, especially the young people out there. Got to start to learn to kōrero to each other about your emotions. It's not a weakness. It's a strength. And if you once you break that barrier down and become supportive of your friends and whānau, you can feel the strength within your heart start to grow. So take that on board. Be bold. But, you know, take on the challenge of asking are you okay. Keep them connected. Staying connected with people is important to everyone's mental well-being. If you're a friend or family member, and your friend or family member is finding it too overwhelming to meet up with other friends, organise a catch-up for just the two of you, or organise a catch-up with your mates. If there's a community class or activity they usually enjoy but can't, they're not doing it anymore, try and get them to go along to it. Might be just to a rugby game, or to the local game, or go and try something new. Go and have a game of darts, or go and do some axe throwing or something like that. Get together. Go and try something new. You might even find a new activity to enjoy. That new activity, it might start something. You might find a passion. In my other role as a parks manager with one of the local councils, I've been involved with encouraging physical activity in our community, and I get a lot of satisfaction out of enhancing the environment for the betterment of others. And I went to a conference yesterday with Sport New Zealand, and they were the statistics were released about participation in sport, and how it dramatically drops off after the age of 11. From the age of 11 to 18, there is a huge decrease in activity across the board. It's not only in New Zealand, it's actually across the world. And so that's the secondary school age, and that's the age of these teenagers that are, some of them are struggling, because they may have dropped off being as physical as they once used to be when they were young kids growing up. Now, being physically active has been found to reduce symptoms and improve the quality of life for people with a range of mental illness and mental health conditions. So encourage people to be active, and I'd encourage you, if you are one of these young people who has found themselves, you know, slipping away from being active, go out there and, you know, get on the bike and go for a walk or something. Doesn't have to be involved in competitive sport. Doesn't have to be competitive sport. It can be active recreation. Just getting out there, going down to the river. Have you tried, you know, go for a dive? You know, that's a good one. Getting into that moana is a really good thing for your tinana, for your wairua. You can just feel the life come back into you when you go and jump in the sea, and you go and have a look at all the life and the gardens in the ocean there, and you can get a kai at the same time, good kai. So, you know, I'd encourage people to get out there and get into the water, have a dive, have a look around, and go for a fish, things like that. Stay active. I think that, you know, that's a mission for New Zealand sport and for all councils and anyone involved in recreation in the next 30 years, is to try and increase participation in physical activity in the teenage, for the teenage people, from the years of basically 12 to 18. After that, it's sort of like there is a natural tendency because of age and other things, but that it does drop off, and the graph does continue to decline, but not as fast as it does in between the ages of 12 and 18. So that's, I see that as there's something there between, there's a correlation between that drop off in physical activity and mental health well-being. So it is a fact that if you stay active, stay do so, just get up there and do something, it's good for your mind. So young folks and everybody, and get out there and be active. Listen to them. Don't be afraid if you don't know what to say. It's better to admit you don't know than avoid the person for fear of saying the wrong thing. So listen to them. It's just listen. You don't have to have all the answers. You don't have to be. You don't have to feel like you have to have the answer for them or the solution. Sometimes they're just looking for someone to talk to. So listening is a big skill too that I think a lot of us could do better. A lot of us could learn how to listen a little bit more closely. And it's not only the listening, it's the observing what's going on and prompting that kōrero so you can listen. So listening's a big thing. Usually your friend or family whānau member just needs someone to listen to them and not judge them or give advice. Keep what they tell you in confidence unless you're worried for their safety. So, yeah, folks, that's I think that's good advice out there. So I might play another song for all the young folks out there. Kia kaha, young people. Welcome back, folks, to Tribal Nations MC Radio here on Arrow FM 92.7 in the Wairarapa. Folks, if you are watching this broadcast on TV, please ignore this time up here. It's I'm pre-recording the show. This is a pre-recorded show, so because I'm not going to be here at the time that this show is meant to be broadcast on Thursdays, but I've got some family commitments, and also I don't think that's quite correct anyway, because I think it's actually daylight saving. But anyway, that's what that is. So I'd just like to thank RFM anyway for their support and guidance with all of us, for Tribal Nations MC, from Darcy and I, for allowing us to do this and teaching us how all these buttons and dials and sliders work. We're still learning, learning our chops about all of this. So thank you, folks, for listening to what we've had to say. Tribal Nations MC, we're on the radio to promote our Rats Riding event, Riding Against Teenage Suicide, which will be in the Wairarapa on Labour Weekend, October the 27th. We're going to be starting in Featherston at the Anzac Memorial on Fox Street. There's registrations down there from 9 a.m. There's going to be a barbecue there, and stands up at 10:30. That means we'll be rolling out of there at approximately 10:30 and heading for a little bit of a ride into the countryside. Hopefully the weather's nice and the weather plays a part for us, and we'll be heading to Martinborough. Then we will be going to Greytown, Carterton and Masterton. Like I mentioned before many times, we're going to be at Farrier's car park at 12:30, and we're going to have a bit of a kōrero and help raise awareness about teenage suicide. So, yeah, teenage suicide, a big, big problem in our community in the last 12, for many, many years. And it's getting worse. The numbers are just getting worse. And Tribal Nations has had enough of it. Tribal Nations has, some have been directly affected by it through many members' whānaus have taken their lives. And we are acutely aware as a group of the pain and the hurt that's associated with this. So once again, our condolences and sympathies go out to all the whānau, all the friends of anyone affected by suicide. It's a terrible thing. So folks, if you notice changes in your whānau, your loved ones or your friends, please encourage them to talk about it, because if you can intervene, many, many examples of the intervention has helped and stopped their intentions, and afterwards they will acknowledge that they are glad to be alive. They are glad to have gotten through that crisis situation where they were in at that time, and it's happened many, many times. It's over and over and over again. So that's what we can do. We can, if we are able to get them to open up, if we are able to talk to each other, young people, do not be afraid about opening up to your friends and saying you're not okay, you're in a place, you're in a bad space. Stop putting on a facade of I'm okay when you're not okay. You know, there's help out there. People love you, but there's support out there for everybody. Please don't do it. Think about, you know, your friends and family. You're better off here than not. When some people think, oh, I'm a burden to the whānau and I'd be better off gone, I'm better off not. No, you're not. You're not. You're not better off gone. You're better off here. You've got a whole life ahead of you. You've got so much to give. And there's so much love out there for you. But sometimes people, when they're in that state, they're not thinking clearly. There is something going on, and like I mentioned before, some of this is exacerbated by a terrible affliction in our community called drug abuse and alcohol abuse as well. Alcohol is a depressant, doesn't do your wairua or your mental well-being any good if you're in a depressed state. It's a depressant anyway. So, you know, mind that drug and alcohol abuse whānau if you're in a bad place. It's not a good, it's not medicine. It's not going to help you out. What will help you out is kōrero, talking about it, seeking some professional help. There are those around you that will listen, and there are support mechanisms out there. There are support services that are available. And like I mentioned before, and I'll mention this again, there's 1737. It's free to call. It's free to talk. It's free to text. You can call that. You can text that. 1737. Lifeline on 0800 543 354. There's Healthline on 0800 611 116. There's Depression Helpline on 0800 111 757 or free text 4202. There's the Youthline. Don't forget Youthline on 0800 376 633. There's the Samaritans on 0800 726 666. And of course, if in an emergency, dial 111. Dial 111 in an emergency. If you come across something that you need some immediate help with, and someone's in immediate danger, you or them, 111. So there, whānau, I think I'll be calling that a day, and I wish you all the best for the upcoming week. Be positive, stay positive, talk nicely to each other, and hopefully we'll see you back here next Thursday on Tribal Nations MC Radio on Arrow FM. Kia ora.
Step one, you say we need to talk. He walks, you say sit down, it's just a talk. He smiles politely back at you. You stare politely right on through. Some sort of window to your right. As he goes left and you stay right. Swing the lines of fear and blame.
Whānau, that's it for me for this week. I'll see you next week, hopefully, on Tribal Nations FM, Tribal Nations radio show on Arrow FM. So hi there, whānau, kia kite anō.